If 50 mL of 0.10 molar zinc bromide is mixed with 50 mL of 2 molar sodium hydroxide, what's going to be the concentration of zinc? So before we do this reaction, in fact, I'll set it up so you understand what we need to be doing here. We're going to set up with zinc. It's going to react with 4 hydroxides to form the complex ion with 4 hydroxide ligands. So what we need to do is figure out the concentration of zinc initially and the concentration of hydroxide initially. So here's my 50 mils times the concentration divided by the 100 mils, the total, and that's going to give me 0.050 molar zinc initially. And here's my 50 mils changed to liters times the concentration, which is 2 molar. So volume times concentration gives me moles, divided by the total concentration, 50 plus 50, gives me 0.95 molar for the hydroxide. Okay, so the zinc's initial concentration is 0.050, and for the hydroxide, it's 0.95. And then my complex ion initially is 0. Okay, and again, we're just setting this up to make the math easier. So that's before the reaction. And then my change is going to be, this is going to go down. We're going to assume it's going to be all used up. And what goes here? You should have said a 4, so that 4 because of the mole ratio. And then my complex ion is going to increase. All right, so this will set up my calculations for our initial for the equilibrium. Okay, so this is going to be 0. This is going to be 0.80. And this is going to be 0.050. All right, so those are going to be our initial concentrations once we set up the equilibrium. Let's do that now. So I'm going to set up the same equation, but this time it's going to be an equilibrium equation. And I'm going to drop down my initial concentrations from what I just calculated. So here's my ice box. All right, so zinc, we're going to say is 0. Hydroxide, 0.80. And the complex ion, 0.050. All right, so this is going to go up plus x. It can only go up and we don't know how much, so it will end up being x. This is going to go up 4x, so we're going to end up with 0.80 plus 4x. And this is going to go down minus x because our ratio of zinc to the complex ion is 1:1, so that's going to be 0.0500 minus x. All right, so the KF value, looking that up, is 3.0 times 10 to the 15th. So it's a huge, huge K value, which means that the equilibrium favors favors the right side very heavily. Okay, so KF is going to equal the concentration of my complex ion over the zinc. And the hydroxide raised to the 4th power. Okay, now let's plug in our numbers. That's going to be 0.0500 minus x. This is going to be x on the bottom, and 0.80 plus x, and that's to the fourth power. Okay, so can we neglect, and we're going to have to, we're going to neglect the x's that are added or subtracted to avoid dealing with that power of 4. Okay, so then our equation becomes 3.0 times 10 to the 15th equals 0.0500 over x, and also on the bottom is 0.80 to the fourth power. So x is going to equal 0.0500 divided by 3.0 times 10 to the 15th. So you can see x is going to be really small with that on the bottom. And 0.80 to the fourth power. X turns out to be 4.1 times 10 to the negative 17th. That's going to equal my concentration of zinc. And then can we neglect X? Well, let's see. 4.1 times 10 to the minus 17th over, we'll take our smallest value here, 0.050 times 100. Well, that's going to be way less than 5%. So, yes. Okay, we can neglect x.